Hi, you've clicked on to today's tropical tidbit for Friday, and over here in the Atlantic, things are starting to get a little bit more active this morning. A lot more cloudiness over in this area of the world. It's interesting to see the convective blowup still continuing at the tail end of this front here in the Gulf of Mexico. Although this isn't really expected to be much of a problem in terms of tropical development, it's always interesting to see these things sit down here and fizzle and bubble because these things at tail ends of fronts can often be troublemakers, especially early in the season with trough splits. Sitting down here over the Gulf of Mexico for a long time. Again, this not really expected to be an issue, but interesting to see nonetheless. We had a little bit of a spin to it yesterday, and an illustration of why these things have to be watched because they do look kind of mischievous, so these things always have to be kept an eye on. But here on the image, the main attraction today, it's fairly obvious where the main concentration of heat is, right in here in this area of the world. There's a tropical wave just west of Jamaica's longitude here interacting with the monsoon circulation over here near Panama. And as I said, we're starting to see that activity flare up across here, but upper ridging is going to start ballooning northwestward with this system as heat starts to get released in the atmosphere and raise pressures aloft, creating more of an upper anticyclone over this feature as things start to move west-northwest very slowly over the next couple of days. You can see there's a little bit of stuff over here in the eastern Pacific. Part of the circulation is on the other side of Central America, so this is going to be a little bit hard for this all to consolidate here on the Atlantic side. And given how far southwest it already is, it's going to be hard to avoid Honduras and Nicaragua, at least part of the circulation. It's possible that if a center of low pressure forms with this, that it tries to squeak by just to the west-northwest of the tip of that coastline. But it's starting to look like if anything is going to consolidate in here, it may have to pass over the tip of Honduras and Nicaragua first before getting to the Yucatan. But it's going to be a little while yet before we start to get any organized area of low pressure. But you can see the bands, slightly cyclonically curved bands of convection, starting to develop with this. That's one thing I usually look for with these monsoonal systems if they're going to try to develop a more defined area of low pressure, is these curved bands of convection. So give it a couple days as it'll start moving west-northwest towards the Yucatan over here. And we're going to have to watch this closely. These are the models going for it here, the latest 6E runs. This is the GFS. A lot farther south, notice near the southern coast of the Bay of Campeche over here by day 5, a lot farther south than the other runs, which were taking it up towards Brownsville and the Mexican-Texas border. The NOCAPS is also farther south here, similar solution, day 6, southern Bay of Campeche, tropical storm, but pretty far south here, not much room over water. The European, still the farthest south of them all, not showing much of anything here because it's so far south in the Bay of Campeche. Not much room to move north at all. Though its ensembles have a lot of member variance in these blue and pink colors, showing disagreement within the members a lot farther north in the operational run, indicating that a lot of the ensemble members from the European are showing the storm farther north in this area of the Gulf than the operational run shows it. The Canadian ensembles show a similar feature. Now, if I go back to the satellite loop here, one of the key things about this little area of disturbed weather is where it's going to cross the Yucatan. If we're going to get development out of it, it's going to want a lot of time over water. So ideally, it would go up here into the Gulf of Honduras where it has time over water in the Western Caribbean and then crosses the Yucatan as far north as possible to get as much time over water as possible to develop. Now, this front over here is associated with a weakness over the eastern United States. If we go over here to the steering layers in the mid-levels of the atmosphere, we can see that the ridge is still way back here over the southeast U.S. and northwest Mexico. There's a trough over the eastern United States, and you can see this break right here in the ridge with the Atlantic Ridge nosing in over here to the east of Florida. So what we have here is we have a little bit of low pressure trying to develop that's going to be coming west-northwest. Now this weakness is going to remain in here for the next 72 hours or so before it starts to really close off and this ridge starts to build northeastward and cut it off. So for the next 72 hours, we're going to have the ability for this to try to gain a little bit of latitude before making it to the Yucatan, and it's possible that we may see this try to get in towards Chetumel, the name of that city right north of Belize there, where Mexico starts on the Yucatan Peninsula. It's possible that we may get it as far north as this area before it hits the Yucatan and then crosses around here. A little bit farther north than some of the models here. A lot of the models started to take it really far south, not get it over very much water over the Gulf of Honduras, and then barely skim the Bay of Campeche here. I think because of this weakness to the north of it, it will get a little bit farther north than that before crossing the Yucatan, but we'll have to see where an area of low pressure decides to consolidate. It's very hard to determine these things until we see a center of low pressure. But either way, once it comes across, it's still going to get curved west by that ridge as this ridge builds back into the north here over the plains, directly to the north of the system, which should curve it west into Mexico, as I mentioned yesterday. And the models have shifted farther south today into this area, but I still feel that Tampico would be a more likely area, right around this area. Plus or minus south or north of this area on the Mexican coastline would be most likely to get this system if a defined area of low pressure develops. Again, a little far out, but that's how I feel right now. And of course, the farther south it tracks, the less likely it is to develop. Right now, it looks like a good chance we'll get this tagged in Invest at some point during the next couple of days. The NRC will likely mention it soon. And a tropical depression is possible with this, probably once it gets across the Yucatan into here. Probably not going to be able to do a whole lot until it crosses the Yucatan. Bay of Campeche will be its best bet. And it won't have a whole lot of time over water here with the steering currents bringing it west right into Mexico again. But we will have a chance to get this to develop. And we may even get Arlene out of it if it organizes well after crossing the Yucatan, but again, we'll have to see how it's looking in a few days after it's had a chance to really develop. So you can see how this pattern that I've been talking about for a while now is working out in this area of the world. We're getting the MJO over our area here. We're getting lots of convection blowing up, and conditions are set to try to get development here. It's going to be tied up a little bit with land, but you can see that the forerunners in terms of the conditions that we were looking for to favor development in this area of the world are coming together, and we indeed have a disturbance that has a chance based on model support here to do a little bit of mischief. So we will have to watch the situation closely over the next several days into next week. All right, that's it for today. Thanks for watching.